This is the chamber of the United Nations Security Council in New York. So in this way, they will all the members of the United Nations in the Security Council, they will sit together and they will discuss regarding any matter or any issue. Now we will study about the Economic and Social Council, the third council. The Economic and Social Council consists of 54 members elected by the General Assembly for a 3-year term. So there are total 54 members in the Economic and Security Council, and they are elected by the General Assembly for a period of how many? 3 years. The main objective of the ECOSOC is to free the world from want. So their main objective is to make the whole world free from want. That means their main agenda is that they, whatever they want or whatever they desire, they should get, and all the raw materials in the world should be available to all the members who are the member of the Economic and Social Council. And its functions are to promote economic growth and social progress. So one of the functions of the Economic and Social Council is to promote economic growth. That means to make the country develop and social progress. Next, to create a spirit of respect for human rights. The next objective is to create a spirit for respect for human rights. That means to every citizen should have all the basic human rights so that they can live their life peacefully. To resolve problems related to health, illiteracy, drugs, employment, status of women, etc. So these are the very important issue which every country have to face, and their main objective is to solve these problem from their members' country. Last objective is to supervise the work of various specialized agencies such as World Health Organization, United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, United Nations Children Funds, International Labour Organization, Food and Agricultural Organization, etc. So the one of the objective of the Economic and Social Council is to look after, or you can say to supervise these organizations which are under the United Nations. Remember the full form of these important organizations, that is WHO, UNESCO, UNICEF, ILO, FAO. This is very important.